candidates, today I'm going to give you the quick and dirty on LRCs and SULEs, which are your major leadership evaluations at OCS. So you've got two LRCs and two SULEs, and altogether they make up a significant part of your leadership grade. However, LRCs and SULEs are distinct in that they are set up to evaluate different aspects of leadership under different circumstances. The big commonality between LRCs and SULEs, outside of them both being leadership evaluations, is the five paragraph order, which I'll mention briefly at the end of this video. Let's talk about LRCs. So LRCs happen in a contained environment. They're basically big stations that you and your fire team need to maneuver through to complete some mission with a time limit of 10 minutes. LRCs are meant to observe your leadership in a scenario where there is no easy solution and there's time pressure on top of that. What the evaluators are looking for is for you to continue making decisions despite the difficulty of your circumstances and to lead your fire team through all of that. My advice is to just keep moving, even if it's laterally. You may have heard that mission accomplishment isn't the most important thing with LRCs. In my experience, that was true. LRCs are more about your ability to keep it together and lead under pressure than about completing the task. Now, SULEs are more of your tactical and mission completion evaluations. So for example, you'll need a NAVMAN, you'll need to know your formations and hand and arm signals, and you'll need to implement the standard operating procedures for locating, closing with, and destroying the enemy. With LRCs, the enemy is notional. With SULEs, you will have Marines who are acting as enemy combatants. SULE 1 is with your fire team, and SULE 2 is with your squad. And for SULEs, mission accomplishment is an important objective, so do not lose sight of that. Concerning the five paragraph order, I'll put together a separate video on that, but the short of it is that there's nothing mysterious or difficult about the five paragraph order. At OCS, you'll have classes and discussions on the five paragraph order, and you'll also receive written formats and notes on the five paragraph order that you can then use to construct your skeleton. In my What to Bring video, I mentioned upgrading to a bigger right in the rain. That's what I did, and I was able to comfortably write down the skeleton and then fill in all the details and use it to brief for SULE 2, for example, without issue. So really, the deal with the five-paragraph order is you just need to review it a couple times and understand the flow of it and what exactly goes where. Otherwise, they're not trying to hide anything from you or be sneaky or make it difficult for you at OCS. Just remember, OCS is all about the basics, and that certainly applies to the five paragraph order. So if you have any questions, as usual, let me know. And as always, remember, it is not about you. Take care.